Helen Keller. She, in the dark, found light brighter than many ever see. She, within herself, found loveliness through the soul's own mastery. And now the world receives from her dower the message of the strength of inner power. One night, there was a terrific fight in the Grand Duke. It began like this. A little French danseuse named Annette was gonna have a child. Still, to make a living, she had to come to work every night and dance with the patrons and drink as much champagne as she could in order to get her commission. But she was not well, and she shouldn't have been there. Of course, if she had had any other way of making a living, she wouldn't have been there. But she didn't have any other way. Feeling badly, no doubt, Annette began to be very spiteful to those clients who didn't think they could afford another bottle of champagne. So one night, the owner of the place asked her not to come back anymore. He was French. She was French. And they spoke the same language fluently. So Annette said some very unpleasant things to the owner. He called an attendant to eject her. Annette would not go. The attendant laid hands on her and pushed her, struggling in her satin evening gown, towards the door. As she passed the last table, Annette seized the patron's champagne bucket, ice bottle and all, and flung it straight at the proprietor at his cash desk behind the bar. Whereupon the attendant slapped Annette to the floor with one blow of his hand. Then it was that Florence, the famous entertainer, that same Florence who snubbed millionaires nightly, arose from her table near the orchestra to defend the poor little French danseuse and her troubles. Florence wore an evening gown of gold and a spray of orchids in her hair. She swept across the floor like a handsome tigress, blocking the path of waiters, who, at the bidding of management, rushed to eject the little danseuse. Florence said, "Don't touch that woman. She's a woman, and I'm a woman, and can't nobody hit a woman in any place where I work. Don't put your hands on that woman." By that time, the little danseuse had risen from the floor and seized another ice bucket, which she sent whirling into space. Customers dodged behind tables. The orchestra struck up "Tuck Me to Sleep in My Old Kentucky Home" to drown out the noise. The waiter did lay hands on the danseuse, but Florence laid hands on the waiter. Then the Negro manager laid hands on Florence, and a battle royale began between the women and those who sided with the women, and the management, and those who sided with the men.
Thank you.